All right, hello. So this is going to be notes filling out our Carnegie book. So if you do not have your Carnegie book right now, I'd like for you to go to the back shelf. It's labeled on the shelf the specific classes and also on the books themselves. I just wrote down your name. So there's one book specified for every student. This book for right now, whenever we complete items, we're not gonna rip those pages out. We're only gonna rip pages out for assignments that we complete, and those typically come out at the end of a lesson. For right now, today, it'll be Wednesday, as you're watching this, we're gonna complete activity 1 and 2. Thursday, you'll complete activity 3. And when you're done with activity 3, then you'll get to the assignment that's at the end of this lesson of 3 activities. Okay, these are all working on translations, right? Tuesday, we worked on guided notes on specific sliding for translations. So this should be very familiar. We're going to further explore that today. All right. So for activity 1, we're going to watch one video when we're done with this. This is on page 35 through 36. You'll watch a second video on activity 2, and those are on the next 2 pages. All right, so for this, it's for number 1, it says place patty paper. Ignore that. We're not really getting to patty paper in this activity, not until I come back. Essentially, what we're doing here is we're taking figure W, and we can see W that is inside this figure right here. We have each point on this figured in order alphabetically capitalized. A says to translate the figure down 6 units, identify the coordinates of the translated figure. So let's just do that right now, and then we'll move on to the other parts of this kind of secondary questions. Now, my recommendation is, right, just start wherever. I'm gonna start first alphabetically. I'm gonna start with A, and I'm gonna count down 6. Now, when we count in any specific direction, make sure that you're counting how many times that you're moving. Sometimes students will count where they start. So an example here, let's say I'm gonna move A down 6. It should look like this. It should go 1. Notice how for that 1 is how many, you're thinking of the grid as a series of squares. It's these, how many sides of these squares am I moving? So that's 1 unit. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So where I end in right there, that is where A belongs, or now it's A prime. So let's get rid of these units here. All right, I'm gonna just put A prime. And we're gonna do the same thing with all the other points. Let's go, looks like counterclockwise, alphabetically, B. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, that looks like that's at the ordered pair 2, -5, right? 2 to the right of the origin and 5 down for -5. That is B prime. Since in figure W, A connects to B, I'm gonna connect A prime to B prime. All right, let's go and move on. Let's go to C. Keep counting down 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. All right. Moving on to D. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That is at the coordinates 6, -3. We'll label this D prime. Let's connect these two. Two more. E. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That's at the coordinates 6, -2. And last one, F. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. All right, right where this 4 is at, oh, we'll label that F prime. Okay, since this figure is called figure W, since we translated this, we performed some type of transformation. This is now figure W prime. So let's go into answer. So we did part A, Right, we translated this entire figure. This all went down 6. I'm just gonna draw an arrow somewhere here. Let's put our point here. Down 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Right, so if I take this right here and I can see, right, A moved down 6, B, C, D, E, and F. Right, all of these are equal, right? They're congruent. It's the same exact figure. It didn't change size. It didn't change shape. So that's good. All right, B, identify the pre-image and the image. We're gonna write that the pre-image is figure W. Or we could say it's the hexagon A, B, C, D, E, F. That's kind of long to write, so we'll just say figure W. And we're going to say that the image is figure W, but we're going to put prime. All right. That just lets us know, okay, what was the original figure? What was the ending figure? What happened there? C, did translating figure W vertically change the size or shape? No. So we're gonna say no. It does say justify our answer though. So how can we tell? We can say, right, sliding something doesn't change its size. We can say all side lengths are the same. So what I mean by this is we could take a ruler, we can measure every side, like let's say line segment AB. If we take a ruler there and we place it along line segment A prime B prime, that's going to be the same size. We can take any other line segment, still going to apply equally. All right. So now let's move on to this table further below. It says complete the table with the coordinates of figure W prime. So we already have all of these vertices. So those are the points on this figure. Already labeled here for A through F. So we're gonna do the same thing, but we're gonna kind of do this now for figure W prime. We're gonna put that here. Okay, so I already just kind of said some of these. I'm gonna put this in red. All right, so A was 2, 5. A prime, if you look at the figure, it is 2, -1. Okay, let's just write these real quick and then we'll notice some things for the next part. B prime is 2, -5. C prime, that is 4 to the right, so positive 4, negative 5. D prime is 6, -3. E was 6, 4. E prime is 6, -2. F is 4, 5. F prime is 4, -1. Okay. All right. Let's notice some things here. So we completed D. Now moving on to E. Compare the coordinates of figure W prime with the coordinates of figure W. What are the values of the coordinates? Or sorry, how are the values of the coordinates the same and how are they different? So, I mean, let's look at the X values. I'm gonna take my highlighter tool. Okay, let's highlight all the X values here. And what can we say about the X values now to our image? So if we look at A to A prime, right, X value is 2, X value is also 2. And I think we can see with the remaining ones, all the X values are the same. So let's write that in. Okay. We'll say the X coordinates are the same. Oops, we say are the same. We'll just leave it at that. We'll kind of leave it short. All right, and now let's look at, now changing my highlighter tool, let's go to orange. Let's look at the Y values here. How are these the same or how are they different? We're gonna compare and contrast. All right, so these, right, just a quick glance at our Y values, you can see, yeah, they're not the same. At least looking from pre-image to image here. Okay, but what can we say is happening here, right? Are they getting bigger? Are they getting smaller? It looks like they're all getting smaller, right? So the question after that is smaller by how much? Okay. So they are all getting smaller. And I think looking at the problem kind of gives us a little bit of a easier context here. They're all decreased by an amount of 6, right? If we take 5, 5 minus 6 is negative 1. Here, 1, 1 minus 6 is negative 5. This next one is also 1, so I'll skip that. We'll say 3, 3 minus 6 is negative 3. And this is actually what we practice. We practice on integer operations. We talked about how you can use a number line to practice adding, subtracting integers. So that's actually what's happening here, is that we're moving down 6. That's why it's all decreasing 6, and that is specifically the Y values here. Okay, so let's write that in. The Y coordinates of the image are 6 less, whoops, 6 less than the values of the Y coordinates on the pre-image. On the pre-image. Okay, now we did talk about this in our guided notes on Tuesday, is that really what you can do is you can, if we're seeing, right, Y minus 6, we're just subtracting 6 to all our Y values, but we're really seeing that visually from the diagram on the coordinate plane to now our table here. So I think hopefully that just further reinforces the point that, right, we could use a coordinate plane if we have access to, right, maybe some type of grid, but not necessary for this. We could always just add or subtract to the X or the Y values depending on whatever we have. Okay. All right, now moving on to the second page of the first activity. All right. So this is the same type of exercise that we just did, but we're kind of changing a little bit. As you can see here, number 2 is saying we have the same figure W. We're gonna copy the vertices. In this case, we're now going to translate them all. We're gonna count a little bit more. We're gonna go 10 to the left. And then it says, we'll draw the figure and then we're gonna label the pre-image and the image. So let's take, we're gonna go in that same order. Let's take A. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Did I count that right? Okay, looks good. And this is at the coordinate negative 8, where I'm moving 8 to the left, and then 5 up. All right, negative 8, 5, right here. And we're gonna label this, since this is our second transformation, being a translation as well, we're gonna say that this is A, double prime. We're gonna put 2 tally marks there, just saying that we've now translated this a second time, so we're not confusing this with our other figure on the previous page. Let's do the same thing with B. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. All right, that is at the coordinate negative 8, positive 1. Negative 8, positive 1. B double prime. You know, I'll just put all the points before I connect everything. Let's do C. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Negative 6, positive 1. And although I'm saying these out loud, we will fill this out on the table. Negative 6, positive 1. We'll go C double prime. D. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. That is at the coordinate negative 4, positive 3. So 4 left, 3 up. D double prime. E. Okay. And then finally, one more. We're going to go with F. Okay. 10 to the left. That is at the coordinate negative 6, positive 5. So 6 left, 5 up from the origin. Okay, now let's connect everything. So this will go here. Just connecting it alphabetically. All right. So this figure, yes, it looks the same. I mean, if I were to take this entire figure, hopefully I got everything, and put it right on there. Yep, it looks just identical to the entire thing. So I think that looks good. Okay. And we're gonna label this figure W double prime. All right. Good, so we did part A. Part B, draw the translated figure in the coordinate plane, we did, and label the figure W prime, then identify the pre-image and the image. For the sake of saving time here, I'm just gonna circle this. The pre-image is right here, figure W, and the image is W prime. Sorry, W double prime. And D, did translating the figure horizontally change the shape, the size of the shape of the figure? This, pretty identical to what we just had earlier. It did not change, so we're gonna put no. And we can still say all figure, we'll say measures are the same. So what I mean by figure measures is all the side lengths are the same, but also like inside the figure, all the angles of the different line segments that are formed, you know, things that are 90 degrees, they remain 90 degrees. Those don't change as well. Okay, same exact shape and size for everything. They're congruent. All right, and then quickly let's label our table here, and then we're done with this activity. We'll move on to activity 2. Okay. It says complete the table with the coordinates of figure W double prime. We did say these out loud, but let's fill these in. Oops. All right. A double prime. All right. We're going to have is negative 8, positive 5. B double prime, negative 8, positive 1. C double prime is negative 6, positive 1. D double prime, negative 4, positive 3. E double prime, negative 4, positive 4. And the last one, F double prime, negative 6, positive 5. All right, now in the last in the last problem, we slid or translated our figure vertically, and we saw how we translated vertically affected the Y value. So let's keep that in mind, right? This time we're translating it horizontally. So is the Y value still being affected, or is it something else? So to the question that we have for E, compare the coordinates of the two figures. How are the values of the coordinates the same and different? We're gonna start with the X values, just like what we did with the last one, and we'll go blue. Okay, so let's highlight our X values here. You don't have to highlight this, but maybe you can, you're welcome to like maybe circle the X values and maybe like draw a square around the Y values. But what do we see here for the X values? Are they getting bigger, smaller? So for the X value in point A, it's 2. And for the X value in point A double prime, it's negative 8. So is that getting bigger or smaller? These are all getting smaller. And the question is by how much? Since we moved this 10 to the left, right? Moving to the left is a negative direction. and that's what it is. They're all decreasing by 10. So we're gonna say the X values, or they will say the X coordinates. Are 10 less than the, we'll just say the preimage. Okay, and then from here, I'll put this in orange. Let's highlight, I'm just gonna draw a single line here. Let's look at the Y values here. Anything happened with that? Right, we look at A to A double prime, those remain 5, B to B double prime, 1, the Y values were not affected. So we're just gonna say the Y coordinates, I'm gonna abbreviate coordinates, it's just C-O-O-R-D. The Y coordinates are the same. Okay. And then let's put some closure on this activity by answering number 3. Make a conjecture about how a vertical or horizontal translation affects the coordinates of any point x, y. So a conjecture is some type of right conclusion that we can think by making kind of like noticing of patterns that we've discovered. Okay, so what can we say? We could say that I'm just gonna put a horizontal translation. What does that affect? That affects the X value of the coordinate. Right, and that's what we talked about, right? For X comma Y, or when you graph a point, right? The X value, you move it either left and right from the origin, so that's horizontal. And the Y value, that's moving it up and down, that's vertical. So let's go and write that in. So a vertical translation affects the Y value. Affects the Y value. Okay, all right, that's been activity 1. We're gonna move on to activity 2. Now, the purpose of this is so that the book kind of complements what we do in our guided notes. These are things that you can use on right our assignments to help us with our assignments. So also that it can help us on our summatives, right? That being right, quizzes and tests. But we'll move on to activity 2 pretty soon. All right, let's go to and